resolving conflict. Step number 5, make peace. Matthew 5 and verse 9, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. As we continue looking at biblical principles or guidelines that we could apply into resolving conflicts, whatever the setting is, when there's a breakdown in human interactions, human relationships, what can we do? So we've been talking about that this week. We said, first of all, we prepare our heart. Number 2, we receive God's empowering to love. Number 3, we receive God's wisdom, so we know what matters to address. Number 4, we sit down and lovingly discuss the matter and address issues of importance. Number 5 in this whole process that we can present is that we resolve the matter in peace. The end objective that we are looking at is peace, a peaceful resolution, meaning that friendship is once again restored and it's done in peace. So it's not done with bickering, grudges being held with each other, or with temporary solutions with the intent of getting back at each other. No, it's done with the intent of peace. So the Bible tells us that peacemakers, they are blessed, and they're the ones who will be called sons of God. Sons of God, God's children, are peacemakers. They work towards establishing peace. And so Romans, the 14th chapter, verses 17 through 19 says this, that the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but it is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. He who serves Christ in these things is acceptable to God and approved by men. Therefore, let us pursue the things which make for peace and the things by which one may edify one another. Go after the things that will result in peace. So in your discussions, in your interactions, the goal is, let's settle this matter peacefully. Let's come to an understanding and a place where both parties are edified, both parties are built up. No one feels like I've been taken advantage of. No one feels like I am the one who's got the wrong side of the treatment, or I'm the one who's got the poorer deal in this whole thing. No, we want to settle it peacefully, and we want to settle it in a way that edifies both, that builds up both. So we work towards it. And the Holy Spirit is there to help us experience righteousness, peace, and joy, because that's an expression of God's rule and dominion coming into that place. And where we walk in righteousness, peace, and joy given to us by the Holy Spirit, there Jesus reigns. There His kingdom is established. So, agree to make peace. Pursue peace in that relationship. Settle matters peacefully. Let's pray. Lord, we ask You for the wisdom and the grace we need as we interact with people. And God, You will help us, wherever there's been conflict, to resolve things in peace. Help us to do this, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.